Have you been hearing the term nano banana lately in the AI world? It sounds like a smoothie flavor, but it's actually an internal code name for one of the most powerful image generation updates we've seen from Google Gemini yet. If you've noticed that your AI images suddenly have better lighting, readable text, and actually follow your instructions, you're likely using one of these new models. Today, I'm going to show you how to get the most out of this update. We're going to look at the best way to structure your prompts. I'm going to walk you through five specific examples, from creating consistent characters to generating accurate text and logos. First, a quick tech note. When we talk about Nano Banana, we're usually referring to the Gemini 3.0 Pro or the updated 2.5 flash image capabilities. The big changes here is that the pictures just don't look prettier. It's that the AI now has better instruction following. It listens to the complex logic much better than before. But even with a smart model, you need a blueprint. I always stick to this four-part formula. One is the subject. Who or what is it? Two, action. What are they doing? Three, context. Where are they? What's the lighting? Four, art style. Is it a photo, a 3D render, or a sketch? Keep that formula in mind, and let's jump onto the computer and see this in action. Here I am in Gemini, and we can quickly turn to Nano Banana. You can see I can just click Create Image here, or when I click Tools, I'm going to click Create Images, then we get the banana up. So the number one question I get is, how do we keep the same character across different images? With this new model, this is much easier. Let's try to generate a specific character first. I'm going to give it this prompt. A close-up portrait of a woman named Sarah with curly red hair wearing a green innovative tech hoodie in a modern office, cinematic lighting. I'm giving her a name, a specific look, and a distinct green hoodie. Let's hit enter. Okay. We have Sarah. Now, traditionally, if I asked for a new picture, the AI would give me a totally different person. But watch this. I'm going to give it this prompt. Generate an image of Sarah from the previous image, now hiking a mountain trail, wearing the same green hoodie, wide-angle shot. I'm explicitly referencing Sarah from the previous image. Let's hit enter. Look at that. The facial features are retained, the hair texture is the same, and the hoodie is consistent. If you're trying to make a storyboard or a children's book, the consistency is a game changer. Next, let's talk about text. AI used to be terrible at spelling. It would give us gibberish. The Nano Banana models have solved a lot of this. Let's go ahead and give this a try. I'm going to go to my Nano Banana, and let's say I need a sticker design for a coffee shop. I want to have specific text on it, and I'm going to give this prompt. A die-cut vinyl sticker design of a cute robot barista holding a coffee cup. The coffee cup says Jamie's Brew in bold, readable, bubble letters, white border, flat vector style. I'm going to hit enter. Notice I asked for bold, readable letters. And there it is, spelled correctly, Jamie's Brew. The ability to render text means you can use this for YouTube thumbnails, logos, a presentation slides, without having to open Photoshop or fix the spelling errors. The one tip I would give is be specific on your text. Tell Gemini Nano Banana exactly what to write. I find when it does make mistakes is when you're telling it to create the text and you haven't been specific on it. The third example is for teachers and business professionals. It's about world knowledge. The AI understands how things work, so we can ask for diagrams. Let's ask for something educational. We're going to use this prompt. A clean, modern infographic illustrating the water cycle. Include arrows showing evaporation, condensation, and precipitation. Use a flat design with a blue and white color palette. Now we're going to hit enter. It usually gets the flow correct, arrows pointing up for evaporation, down for rain, and it's just not painting a picture, it's visualizing a concept. This is perfect for slide decks where you need a custom graphic that doesn't exist on stock photo sites. Now for something creative. Sometimes you have a photo, but you want it to look like a drawing, or a clay, or a cartoon. We can use the upload feature for this. I'm going to upload a photo of myself. And now I'm going to prompt it to change the style but keep the structure. This is my prompt. Reimagine this image as a vintage 1920s charcoal sketch. High contrast, rough paper texture, keep the facial structure. I'm going to go ahead and submit. It kept the pose and the composition but completely changed the medium. You can do this with claymation style, pixel art, or even oil painting. It's a great way to make your profile picture stand out. Finally, let's look at localized editing. Sometimes you get a nearly perfect image, but it's missing one key element. Here I have a generated image of a desk, but it's totally empty. I want a laptop right here in the middle. Now, the great thing about this new model is that I don't need a complicated lasso tool. The AI understands the context of the scene. I just need to tell it what to add, and it will figure out the best place to do it. So in the prompt box, all I'm going to say is add a silver open laptop here displaying a spreadsheet. I'm going to hit enter. By saying add here, the AI looks for the most logical open space on the desk surface. Look at that. It analyzed the lighting and perspective, and it inserted the object perfectly. This saves so much time compared to regenerating the whole image, hoping for the right result. If you want to control exactly where you want something added, try this. So I just uploaded the same image here, and I'm going to click on it, and notice we have a few tools in here. I'm just going to go ahead and make a circle right here, and I'm going to click done. Now, what I'm going to do is add this prompt. Place a parrot where I circled and remove the circle. I'm going to go and hit enter. And look at this. We now have the parrot on the ledge and the circle removed. I have one more bonus tip for you. And this one is huge for anyone doing branding or print on demand. We've talked about generating images from scratch, but what if you want to place your own design onto a real product? Let me show you how to create an instant photorealistic mockup. I have two images here. First, the perfectly blank white ceramic coffee mug, and second, a retro coffee logo design. I want the AI to wrap it around and curve on the mug and apply realistic lighting to it. I have the two images uploaded into chat, and here's the prompt I'm going to use. Combine these images, place the vector logo from the second image onto the front of the white coffee mug from the first image. The logo should be curved realistically around the mug's surface and follow the studio lighting, showing highlights and shadows consistent with the ceramic material. And I'm going to hit enter. Notice I'm asking for two specific things, wrap it around the curve and match the lighting. Look at the result. This is what separates a basic edit from a professional one. See how the logo isn't just flat, it actually bends around the curve of the ceramic. And look at the lighting. There's a slight highlight on the right side of the logo matching the light source on the mug. It looks like a real printed product. You can use this to test your designs on t-shirts, tote bags, or packaging in seconds without needing a professional photographer. Before we wrap up today, I have two quick power tips. First, don't forget the aspect ratios. If you're making YouTube short or TikTok, add aspect ratio 9:16 to the end of your prompt. If you want a wallpaper, use 16:9. Second, if you have access to Gemini events, try toggling on thinking mode if your prompt is really complex. It takes a few seconds longer, but it reasons through the prompt before drawing, which often fixes issues with hands or complex scenes. I've put a list to all the prompts I used today in the description below so you can copy and paste them and try them out yourself. Let me know in the comments, are you going to use this for logos, characters, or just for fun? Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next week with more tech tips and tutorials.